ఆదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశర్షద్భ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన గణ ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్రవేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్ అండ్ మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, వెల్త్, హెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మి కటాక్షం టు యూ అండ్ ఎంటైర్ యువర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత చాప్టర్ నంబర్ 4 వర్స్ నంబర్ 16. శ్రీ భగవాన్ వాచ కిం కర్మ కిమ కర్మేతి కవయోప్యత్ర మోహితాః తత్తే కర్మ ప్రవక్ష్యామి యజ్ఞాత్వా మోక్షసే శుభాత్. లార్డ్ కృష్ణ ఇస్ ద గ్రేట్ టీచర్ ఆచార్య. హీ నోస్ వేర్ టు పుట్, వాట్ టు పుట్, హౌ టు పుట్ ఇన్ టు అవర్ మైండ్ బికాస్ ద లాంగ్వేజ్ ఆఫ్ ద మైండ్ ఇస్ యునీక్. Sometimes, you know, you have to be penetrated with a certain language. That language may it gets confused. Like, you know, karma and akarma, avidya and vidya, nitya and anitya. So, like, they are like opposites, like a black and white. So, there is no connection between black and white and light and darkness. So, this mind has the capacity to experience the oppositeness. That oppositeness, black cannot be white, white cannot be black, like light cannot be dark, dark cannot be light. So that understanding capacity the mind which has, there Acharya triggers there. So Krishna, though he speaks sometimes as the Paramatma, so the language must be understood by ourselves. And he also has a spectacular way of penetrating in our buddhi. So buddhi, how does it work? In the last chapter, he taught yajna bhava. This yajna bhava, yajnyarthat karmano nyatra, it's a marvelous invention. Nowhere it is taught. Karmapala is taking place by the attitude which is called ahankara. Now in this verse, actually especially in the fourth chapter, he is just teaching us how to withdraw ourselves from the karmapala, being in the karma like the lotus when it exists in the mud, but it is not affected by that. Have you ever asked, oh lotus, how you are maintaining? So you are not sticking with the mud. Though you are in the mud, but you are coming as a beautiful way, and you have become an emblem, a motto in India. We use the lotus as the motto. A flower for India means lotus. It's a blooming, fantastic, but it comes from the mud. And ask fish how you survive without sticking the water. So fish is always dry. You may say that there are some chemicals. Why can't we have the chemicals being in the karma and unaffected by the karma? Is there any chemical? Is there any solution? Is there any that formula? That formula is given here. That formula is given, but don't get carried away. Don't get confused by the word karma and akarma. Karma is nothing but action. Action, there are two kinds which we have seen already, inside and outside. When I think something, I want to do something, we call it action. And something is going around, the world is, you know, the earth is revolving and rotating and going around the sun. So many planets are going around that. Air is flowing, water is flowing, fire is burning, everything is nothing but action. But Bhagavan Krishna here, wait, wait, just close your eyes and realize what is going on in you. That's a simple technique. Close your eyes. Can you see The mind cannot be stopped by closing your eyes. Yes, of course, I can feel it. So there is no door for the ear. Ear always hearing. Yes, I can also feel that. So why is going on? Sometimes you become mad about thinking. So thinking cannot be stopped. Will it be stopped? No, that's what the problem is. That's what karma is. Whether you wish or not, they are on. Always they are taking place. Because you are in the world. World is nothing but karma phala, the made up of karma, the product of karma. So when you realize you are nothing, the product of karma, you should realize one thing. You cannot avoid the karma. You cannot avoid the karma. In the second chapter and third chapter, he clearly said, don't be with inaction. Inaction means what? Don't keep yourself, don't wish to keep yourself a mum, doing nothing. Now here he talks about akarma. Even intelligent people, they are confused to judge what is akarma and what is karma. Now in the last chapter he said that doing nothing, sitting quiet is not called akarma. Every one of us know. And you may also say that this is not big deal. What is there? Karma. I know karma and I know akarma. No. We don't know karma. There are two more words. Action and reaction. We have to be very thorough and clear with these two words. What are they called? Action. What are the call reaction? So when somebody comes, say, hi sir, you reply hi. Is it action? Is it a reaction? When somebody scolds at you, you get angry and you want to do something, you are doing something. If that person is your boss, you will be showing that action means anger through some other work. You will collapse something and you will miss to pass some message. What is very important to be passed? I know a person, so they were friends studying together, very well studying together. Once that person, you know, one of those friends, he just put others' notebook in the well. We show the anger in different way. Jealousy is the reaction. Anger is the reaction. Fear makes to react. So whatever the action comes by the imbalanced emotions or emotions, they can be called as the reaction. Now reaction is not talked about here. Krishna is specifically very much careful. He is not bringing that topic here. Karma means it's a proper karma. Karma means what? So what you need really from your side. You are not thinking about, you know, even while fixing goal also, we are carried away. Now, because our mind is occupied, our mind is, you know, penetrated, brainwashed. I'm using the word brainwashed. We all of us are brainwashed people. Because so many ads are going on, and so many ads, you know, nothing wrong in that, because they are manufacturers, they want to sell their product, therefore they are spending lots of money to prepare, to create ad. Those ads are penetrating always. You know, have you thought about the ad? All of them are not more than 2 minutes. Within 2 minutes, they have to show entire the lifespan and so many things. A baby grows to be an old person. So within that, they wanted to sell the product. They use lots of emotions of that. So there are lots of these ads are shown everywhere. Automatically, your brain is washed. You are brainwashed. Now, whatever the product you need, if you are hungry, so when you want to ask something food, Now that ad will be sitting inside. You are not going to ask something healthy. You will be asking that which was attracted by the ad, advertisement. So there were all those things are wrong. They are not action. They are reaction. Now, do we live with action or do we live with reactions? If your life is filled with reactions, my God, God has to save you. You have to worship Lord Balaji very seriously. No, I'm not doing negative aspect here. We have to become aware what is action, what is reaction. So reaction makes hell. Always reaction makes hell. If somebody is doing against to you, it is not needed you have to give them back as they give. No. Apne ko lagu mein rakh. You have to be controlled enough to think. So you have to think if somebody is doing wrong things, if somebody is scolding at you, if somebody is saying that you are an absolute idiot, immediately if you take it, how can he say me as an idiot? So I have to throw him. You are idiot, your father idiot, your mother idiot, your grandfather idiots. So you have to reply the back immediately. Why he is saying that? Because that is not action. Because emotionally he is imbalanced now. So when that person is emotionally imbalanced, that imbalanced emotions are coming as the reaction. You need not to act for that reaction. Because when you are controlled enough, you can think one step further. One step further means, so you are not going to respond to this activity which comes. You can think about why he does it. What can be the cause he does it? So now, this between the action and the reaction, there are lots of understanding is required to set yourself perfect with the state of action. You need to work a lot. First, you just realize, am I driven by the action or reaction? If you are driven by the reaction, you have to reduce it. Otherwise, Krishna cannot be penetrated in you. This reaction, how to get rid of reaction? Just be aware. Be aware. And you have to know the varieties of the karma phala which was listed in the last chapter. Now here he says, kim karma, kim akarma iti kavayaha api atra asmin vishaye mohitaha. Even intelligent people also are deluded to judge which is akarma, which is karma. But normal people, even they are confused to judge between karma and pratikarma. The pratikarma is the reaction. You have to reduce the reaction. These reactions, even it is said, it is going to be said as a nishiddha karma. But nishiddha karma is something else. Now the secret, don't get confused. Now you think about karma and pratikarma, action and reaction. So your life should not be endowed with reaction. You reduce it. You reduce them. You reduce them. You should not attracted by so many other things. If at all your mind is attracted, you think carefully whether it is right or not. You don't act instinctively to give them back. You don't become mechanically. So mechanically when you work, when you learn to ride bicycle first time, you are riding, that is action. So then when you become mechanically that riding the bicycle, now they are not considered as the action. Actions needs a complete awareness. When you perform action with awareness, my God, that action will bring heaven to you. Therefore, Krishna is very careful when he uses the word karma and akarma. Just he is not saying anything. Just he says that there are two things, karma and akarma. So you have to know both of them, they are very subtle. Even intelligent people miss. They slip to understand properly. Satye karma pravakshyami. I'm going to teach that karma, that secret. Now the karma means the secret of that karma, the flow of karma. Here he is not talking about the bhavana. He is talking about the flow of karma. Because the mind has got its own weakness to realize. That we will come later. Aham pravakshyami yajnatva mokshase ashubhat. Yajnatva ashubhat mokshase. By knowing which you will get rid of papa and punya, entire karma phala. The same thing yajna bhava will protect with you. But here he puts in different angle. It's more deeper than the third chapter. It's a formula. It's a very much, it's a valid formula. You have to be focused enough to realize it. Just he says, by knowing which you will get rid of all karma phala. So that thing I am going to discuss. Okay. Now he goes to the next verse. Let us read it. Karmano hyapi bodhavyam bodhavyam cha vikarmanah akarmanascha bodhavyam. Gahana karmano gatihi. As we have seen in the last verse, you should be endowed with action first. You should have been reduced reactions. For that you have to sit in a place. You give at least 10 minutes for your sake. We have to give no option. We have to give 1 hour the sharira for yoga abhyasa. Whatever the abhyasa, but Shastra prescribes, do yoga. So yoga, purposely you are controlling your pranas. You know, the glory of yoga is not controlling, not giving only the exercise for the physical muscles. No, yoga gives physical stretch and the physical twist and the physical bending at the same time. Yoga also works to balance our pranas. Prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana. So these 5 pranas are filled in our body. This 5 prana, imbalance of this 5 prana makes hell. Those imbalanced prana alone causes the disease for our body. So yoga, it directly hits the prana. It helps us to set ourselves. And you sit at least 10 minutes in a day for a meditation. You do nothing, just sit and observe your mind. You just sit and observe your mind means to be witness. So when you witness your mind, thought comes and that thought will go. The condition is you should not wait for any thought. You should not be carried away by any thought. Will it be possible or not? Yes, of course. When you sit, you should be calm and quiet. So when you are carried away by the thought, for example, when you sit, you know, before sitting in the puja, we have to work a lot, that we have seen already. When you want to sit for the meditation, you have to work hard. After sitting for the meditation alone, you may realize that somebody will come by 10 o'clock. So you might have given appointment or some memory. Something, you know, at that time will pop out. You just look at it. You need not to be carried away. So once you are carried away means what? You are thinking and going behind that thought. Thoughts are like chain. They will pull one thought to another thought, another thought to another thought. So that's a chain like anything. And you also will jump like a monkey, one tree to another tree. So that's the attitude of the mind. Just you focus. And once you realize you are carried away by a thought, that thought will be dropped. That is the secret. Now this example, don't forget. Once you sit calm and quiet in a place and observe your mind, when thought comes, you may go along with the thought. Once you become aware that I am carried away by this thought, that thought, you will be dropped from that thought. And note my language, you will be dropped from that thought. And you should not wait for a new thought. Don't wait for that. Not to be in a hurry. So duniya kahin pe nahi jayega. The world won't go anywhere. You are the universe. You are the world. So unless until you collapse yourself, the world will be very much exactly the same. So when we learnt 3.5 years course, we were not allowed to study, even to read newspaper, to listen to newspaper, no message from outside. So one of my guru, he used to maintain it. No TV, no radio, no newspaper. Can you think? It was like a prison, like anything. So we felt hell first time. Then slowly all those things makes you to react. It causes for the reactions. But when it was stopped, after 6 months, after you know first few months, it was like a great punishment in our life, because our ears, eyes, all mind, attention were craving for some worldly message. We want to hold the message. Don't read everyday morning newspaper in the beginning itself. Newspaper is past, completely karmas, karma phalas. You may read after 10 o'clock. You just go for spiritual practice. Do yoga, do meditation. You have to be firm first with you. Then you can jump into the world. That's what, you know. After few months, slowly we got back. After 6 months, my God. So some inner peace could be felt, because we were fixed a tight schedule: prayers, classes, yoga, lunch, dinner, breakfast, prayers, classes. My God, that was the ashrama's life. So now when you prepare yourself, after 2 years, you know, when we happened to read some newspaper, we felt, you know, boring. We just throw it out. Then after 3 years, I had to read the news, because I have become administrator. I had to read the newspaper, unaffected by the messages, news. That's what the mind we need. We need to have a proper mind, a prepared mind, that which is aware enough to discuss about the karma. Now he introduces karmanaha bodhavyam, vikarmanaha bodhavyam, akarmanascha bodhavyam. Three things are everything: karma, little bit added, you know. Karma to be understood, vikarma to be understood, akarma to be understood. Now karma means action. Action means not reaction, it's action. So what you will, what you need really, you make effort for that. You are not reacting. So reacting is different than the responding. Responding with conscious enough. Responding with conscious enough means you have to respond to the world. You have to respond to your body, but not reacting to the world. So when mosquito is biting, you know, you do like this, it's a reaction. When mosquito bites, okay, I'm not going to harm that mosquito even, because I don't have rights. I don't have, human being don't have the rights to kill any creature. That is the law, ahimsa paramo dharma. So that dharma is the fundamental dharma. We have to stick with that. That is the glory of India. That is the glory of our sanatana dharma too. So now I'm not going to kill that. I'm very much controlled and aware myself, and I will do phew or something, or I should have a mosquito mat. Okay, mosquito mat is not a mat, it's a net. Mosquito net, mosquito mat also will kill the mosquito. So small amount adharma is also not permitted in our shastra. Now he see, karma has to be known. Karma means that action to be understood. Okay. Then vikarma to be also known. Vikarma means what? Nishiddha karma, the karmas which are prohibited by the Shastra, every man must be taught. In the schools, we have to teach children what we avoided first. As I told you, we don't have rights to kill any creature. Okay? Then the third one is akarma, to be also understood. And also he is adding one more line, gahana karmano gatihi. The flow of, you know, the flow of karma is very subtle and very deep to understand. You don't know which karma gave this janma, and we don't know which thought, a simple thought, will make 10 more janmas. We have to be very careful with our karma. So simple, you know, one thought would have channelized, deviated, diverted your entire life. So like one person, one of my students, he came, yes Swamiji, what you said was right. It was only one thought. My God, I should have been alert. And I thought, okay, he is saying something. I asked, you know, what was it? No, just, you know, when this bride was shown to me, the girl was shown to me, I had a thought, Swamiji, so she is good. That's all. My life entirely changed, Swamiji. I cannot comment on this because I don't know problem where it belongs to, whether you have the problem or she has the problem. No, I don't. I am very careful. But a single thought can divert. A single incident can divert. The small incident, people become like a terrorist. You know, terrorist, even they are human being. So wrongly understood. So something went wrong, emotional decision, so some reaction, so they're making hell their own life. You cannot be happy by killing other creature, by killing others, by harming others. It is impossible to maintain the happiness, peaceful mind. Then it is what? It's like a giving self-punishment like. So he says that the first thing we have to realize, karma is so deeper. Why? Because when you are sitting in the train, if next train is moving, immediately you may have the experience your train alone is moving, isn't it? That's the weakness of the mind. Karma is beyond our mind, because karma is also product, mind is also karma's product. Therefore, we have to be very careful. The mind doesn't have the capacity to judge karma, whether it is happening here or it is happening somewhere else. When you are sitting in the train is moving, you feel all the trees are going, running behind. You may say that that's a sign, Swamiji, it's a perception. Yes, it's a perception, that's what I'm saying. So it has to, you are moving that, okay, they are moving opposite side. So if you are moving, they also move. That's the law. When you move, they should move. That moving is the action. That action, mind has got limited capacity to judge the action. So that the earth is revolving in a fast way, the mind doesn't know. The mind says sun is going around the world, around the earth. The stars are moving, but earth alone is moving. Mind doesn't have the capacity to judge whether karma is going here or karma is happening outside. The mind is so limited. We are not going to depend on this mind when we discuss about the karma. Karma is the magic. Sometimes the karma phala, whether you don't know where it has taken place. It's a very unique phenomenon, the subject matter about karma. We will continuously discuss, and don't get confused, okay? Be relaxed. Karma is a formula by which we can get moksha. No doubt in it. we have Shraddha on Krishna, Krishna will lead us properly. We'll see you in the next session. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Now